Welcome in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord be with you and also with you. It's great to welcome you to our worship today. So glad you could be with us. Whether you're watching online in Morton and Riddlesden or anywhere else in the country or indeed anywhere else in the world, welcome. It's great to have you with us. This week our Lent groups begin. We're doing one on a Tuesday evening at 7:30, studying Sam Wells's book, A Cross in the Heart of God. And that's an opportunity to think again about what the cross is all about, what Jesus was doing when he died on the cross, using material from the Old Testament and the New Testament, and helping us to come to a greater understanding of what Jesus did when he died for us on the cross. That's Tuesday evenings at 7:30, and then on Thursday afternoons at 2:30, we're going to be studying and using a booklet called For Such a Time as This. It's a 6-session study course exploring ecological justice, so something that's very topical. Both those Lent groups are done by Zoom, and you can get the code from me. You'll find it in the email that has been sent out this weekend, and if you're not sure what to do, get in touch with me. Apart from that, our regular activities will take place next week. Holy Communion at 10 o'clock at St Mary's, and that will be live streamed as usual on Wednesday, and St Luke's Church open for private prayer on Wednesday afternoon between 2 o'clock and 4 o'clock. And now we come to our opening prayer. Loving God, thank you that you call us to be your people. Help us, as we come to worship you, to see ourselves as you see us. Give us faith to hear your words of love beyond some of the hard reality of our lives. May your Holy Spirit guide and inspire us to recognise your presence in all we do. Amen. And now you can join in singing our first hymn, The Kingdom of God is Justice and Joy. It's number 569 in our hymn books.
Jesus restores what seemeth destroyed.
come to the prayer of confession. Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, returned from the Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, where for 40 days he was tempted by the devil. Let us confess our sins, remembering before God the times when we have fallen from temptation into sin. Lord Jesus, you stepped from water to wilderness, from God's voice to the taunting voice of the enemy. In the wilderness of today's world, we face many enemies, many temptations. Forgive us for succumbing to selfishness, greed, lust, anger, power. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, sometimes difficult times follow fast on the heels of one another, and it's hard to keep our focus on you. Forgive us. Help us not to wallow in self-centeredness, but to remember your promises and recognize you in those you bring alongside. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, forgive us when our minds fail to focus on you and your word. Help us to remember that no matter what we're going through, you've been there before us. Whether we're swimming in the warm waters of your love or journeying through the arid wilderness, help us not to lose sight of your hand guiding us to eternal glory. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. And we listen to the singing of the Agnus Dei. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. May Almighty God, who sent his Son into the world to save sinners, bring you his pardon and peace, now and forever. Amen.
The reading is taken from Mark 1, verses 9 to 15. Not long afterwards, Jesus came from Nazareth in the province of Galilee and was baptized by John in the Jordan. As soon as Jesus came up out of the water, he saw heaven opening and the Spirit coming down on him like a dove. And a voice came from heaven, "You are my own dear Son, I am pleased with you." At once the Spirit made him go into the desert, where he stayed for 40 days, being tempted by Satan. Wild animals were there also, but angels came and helped him. After John had been put in prison, Jesus went to Galilee and preached the good news from God. "The right time has come," he said, "and the kingdom of God is near. Turn away from your sins and believe the good news. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
We join in singing our next hymn, 40 Days and 40 Nights. It's number 121 in our hymn books, though with altered words. Loving God, we thank you that you give us your word, the Bible, to teach us, to encourage us and to inspire us. Speak to us now that we may hear your voice and follow your way, for Jesus Christ's sake. Amen. The heart of today's Bible reading takes place in what is traditionally described as the wilderness, the desolate area that runs down from Jerusalem to the east and the southeast towards the Jordan Valley and the Dead Sea. Some versions of the Bible translate it as desert, which is actually what it is. But I think the translation wilderness best captures the meaning of the word and also the ambiguity of whether or not the wilderness or desert is a good place to be. The key thing about it is the absence of people. Wilderness and the absence of people also describes well the situation that most of us are facing today, and have been indeed since the beginning of the pandemic. Many people we know have not seen loved ones since the beginning of the crisis. Many people we know have hardly been out of their home or their flat for months. Some towns and villages are all but empty of people and full of shuttered shops and deserted offices. All of us are missing hugs, handshakes, and the other physical aspects of family and friendship. So what can we learn from today's Bible reading that might encourage us and help us? First, we're reminded of the reality and challenge of evil. The Gospel of Mark emphasises one particular aspect of Jesus' ministry, his work of driving out demons and releasing individuals who are held captive by evil forces. That's introduced here by the 40 days Jesus spent in the wilderness being tempted or tested by Satan. Mark's Gospel, unlike the Gospels of Matthew and Luke, doesn't give us any example of those temptations, nor does it tell us in so many words that Satan was defeated. Indeed, the confrontation between Jesus and Satan continues throughout Jesus' ministry. The conflict remained real. As we watch the news on television or read the paper, we see and hear of some of the real and damaging results of life under lockdown. A huge increase in cases of domestic abuse. Children and young people with severe mental health problems. People of all ages experiencing crippling loneliness and real anxiety. Jesus came with a message of good news for all. The time is fulfilled. The kingdom of God has come near, he said. But his message also required people to turn away from their sins, to repent and believe. Today, we may not want to talk in terms of demon possession, but there's no doubting the reality of evil. Secondly, we note that although Jesus did not have other people around him in the wilderness, he was not on his own. He had the voice of God his Father ringing in his ears from his baptism, as we heard, "You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased." Jesus also had the support of angels who ministered to him. And he had, after all, been sent out into the wilderness by the Holy Spirit, who never left him. I hope we have heard frequently enough the message that God loves us, each one of us, that God is with us, each one of us. I hope too that each of us throughout the whole pandemic, and especially in these last long weeks of lockdown, have had visits from angels, whether they be supernatural angels whispering God's love into our hearts at our most vulnerable moments, or human angels bringing food and other supplies to our doors. Maybe even the delivery drivers from supermarkets would count as angels today, ministering to our needs. God the Holy Spirit is with us, both encouraging us and helping us to think about what we can do for others. Thirdly, I hope that for us, like for the people of Israel in the wilderness for 40 years and Jesus in the wilderness for 40 days, I hope these 40 days of Lent will be a positive time of preparation for all that is to come. Certainly, we should pray that these days will prepare us well for the good news of Holy Week and Easter, for the annual celebration of the victory of Jesus over sin and evil and death. But we can also pray that the next 40 days will be a time of preparation for the new era when lockdown is over, when the fear of mixing with other people is over, when we can again welcome into our homes other people and enjoy friendship and fun together. In the Church of England's ordination service, those present are told that priests are to be messengers, watchmen, and stewards of the Lord. They are to teach and to admonish, to feed and provide for God's family. And this is the bit I want to highlight. They are to search for God's children in the wilderness of this world's temptations and to guide them through its confusions, that they may be saved through Christ forever. I'd like to think that this is the job not just of the priest, not just my job, but the task of all of us as we share in what is sometimes called the priesthood of all believers. I'd like to think that church people have been and will continue to be in the forefront of looking out for neighbours and the most vulnerable members of our community. But I know it's not something that we can take for granted. Today's Bible reading on the first Sunday of Lent reminds me of the reality and challenge of evil. It encourages me to remember that even when there are no other people around, we are not on our own, because the God who loves us is always with us. And it challenges me to make good use of the present wilderness as a time of preparation for all that will come about in the weeks and months ahead. We may not yet know what the future holds, but we do know who holds the future. He invites us all to turn away from sin and believe in the good news, because the kingdom of God has come near. Amen. Now let us affirm our faith in Jesus Christ, the Son of God. Though he was divine, he did not cling to equality with God, but made himself nothing. Taking the form of a slave, he was born in human likeness. He humbled himself and was obedient to death, even the death of the cross. Therefore God has raised him on high and given him the name above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow and every voice proclaim that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. We join in singing our next song, Christ Be In My Waking. It's number 606 in the hymn books.
Christ be in my waking as the sun is rising, in my day of working with me every hour. Christ be in my resting as the day is ending, calming and refreshing, watching through the night. Christ be in my gladness for the joy of living, thankful for the goodness of the Father's hand. Christ be in my waking, as the sun is rising, in my day of working, with me every hour. Christ be in my resting, as the day is ending.
Let us pray. First of all, the special prayer for today, the collect for the first Sunday of Lent. Heavenly Father, your Son battled with the powers of darkness and grew closer to you in the desert. Help us to use these days to grow in wisdom and prayer, that we may witness to your saving love. In Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now we pray to the Lord for courage to give up things that distract or are harmful, and to give ourselves to him this Lent. Give your church the courage to give up her preoccupation with herself and to give more time to your mission in the world. We pray for all who live or work in the parishes of Morton and Riddlesden. Lord, meet us in the silence, give us strength, and hear our prayer. Lord, graciously hear us. Give your world the courage to give up war, bitterness and hatred, and to work for peace and justice for all. We pray for all who are victims of human brutality, especially in Yemen, Myanmar, Russia, China, and even in our own country as well. Lord, meet us in the silence, give us strength and hear our prayer. Lord, graciously hear us. Give us the courage to give up quarrels, strife and jealousy in our families, neighbourhoods and communities. We pray for all who we find difficult, and for all who find us difficult. Lord, meet us in the silence, give us strength and hear our prayer. Lord, graciously hear us. Give us the courage to give up our selfishness as we try to live for others, and to give time, care and comfort to the sick. We pray especially for all who are ill with COVID, at home, in hospital or in care homes, and for all who are looking after them and ministering to their needs. Lord, meet us in the silence, give us strength and hear our prayer. Lord, graciously hear us. Give us the courage to give up our fear of death and to rejoice with those who have died in faith. Especially we lift to you all those we know who have recently been bereaved. Lord, meet us in the silence, give us strength and hear our prayer. Lord, graciously hear us. And we have a moment of quiet for our own personal prayers. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. As our Saviour has taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and for ever. Amen. Our final hymn is number 702, Lead Us, Heavenly Father, Lead Us. Christ give you grace to grow in holiness, deny yourselves, take up your cross and follow him. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen. Well, thank you so much for joining in our worship today. It's been great to have your company. I hope you have a good week ahead and stay safe. And just before you go, here's a message from the Bishop of Leeds to thank you for all the contributions that you have made to the life of the church and indeed of the diocese over the last few months.
Gave us a script for the year 2020, and that situation carries on into 2021. And the unprecedented changes that were thrust upon us, the challenges of having to be the church in uncharted territory were immense. And yet our clergy, our lay leaders, our parishes, our church officers have adapted remarkably and shown enormous creativity with local sensitivity to those in need. We've said all the way through that the way we love our neighbour is by making sure that they are safe and prevented from unnecessary infection. And I want to thank all our parishes for the sheer creativity, for the immense work and thought and prayer and concern that has gone in the last year to maintaining worship in various forms and to keeping the church open even when some of the buildings were closed. We face financial challenges as a diocese that won't come as any surprise because of the nature of the challenges we faced in the last 12 months. But that isn't the end of the story. There have been many encouragements along the way. And I really want to thank you for how you have met those challenges, for your flexibility and commitment, and for your trust as we continue as a diocese to look at how we're going to mitigate some of the impact of COVID on the Diocese of Leeds. But the key thing is this: thank you for your generosity, thank you for your maintained giving, and thank you for the grace which reflects the generous grace of the God whom we serve. We look to the future with continued challenges, but we look with commitment, with faith, with hope, and in love, love for one another, which is rooted in our love of God. Thank you for all you have done, all you are doing, and all that we together will do as 2021 proceeds into an uncertain future. May God bless you all.